In this video, I'm going to talk about the concept of random seed, and also I'm going to talk about numpy.random.seed in numpy package. And also by the end of the video, we are going to talk about random.seed in the random module in Python programming language. So please stay tuned. Now let's take this example. Suppose that I want to roll a dice with the Python. So rolling a dice is equivalent to generating random integer numbers between 1 to 6. And suppose that I want to do this stuff in Python and using the NumPy package. In order to do so, that's very simple. I import the NumPy package as np. Then I simply type np.random. It means from the NumPy package, I want to use the random section of that NumPy package. And remember that this NumPy package has different sections for different things. For example, it has a section called linear algebra, which is used for doing linear algebra stuff. But also it has a section called random, which is used for dealing with random stuff. So I simply type np.random. It means from the NumPy package, I want to use the random section of that NumPy package. And then I want to use a function called randint, which is used for generating random integer numbers. So I want to generate random integer numbers between 1 to 6. So I should pass 1 and 7. And maybe you ask why 7 and not 6, because this value is exclusive, not inclusive. So if I want to include 6, then I should write 7, because remember that this value is exclusive. That's it. And then I should simply pass size equals to 3, because as I have mentioned, suppose that I want to generate 3 random integer numbers between 1 to 6. It is equivalent to rolling a dice for 3 times. And then I store a result, let's say, in a variable, let's say called x. Now if I print the x variable, you can see here is the result, and it is equivalent to rolling a dice and seeing 4 the first time, and the second time you roll a dice, seeing 3, and the third time you roll a dice, for example, you may see 4. That's it. And if I run the code again and again and again, you can see it is possible to get different results. Why? Because it's exactly like rolling a dice, which is totally random, and this process is also random. So whenever you roll a dice, it is possible to get different results, and also it is possible to get the same results. For example, if you roll a dice and see 6, it is possible to roll a dice and again see 6, and it is possible to roll a dice and again see 6. Of course, the probability of that event is not very high, but it is possible. So this is the reason I use the term possible. So whenever I run the code, it is possible to get different results. Why? Because it's a random process. And now suppose that I'm a teacher of a small class, and these are my students, Muhammad, David, Ali, and Alex. And suppose that I want to define a homework for these guys, and they're going to do their homework. And for doing their homework, they need 3 random numbers between 1 to 6. And this is not an imaginary example. This is a real example. Because as you know, there are some subjects like, for example, bank queue simulation, which, for example, in this subject, students want to simulate the bank queue. And in order to do their homework, they need, for example, 3 initial random numbers from the normal distribution or whatever distribution it is. So generally, in order to do their homework, they need to start with, for example, let's say 3 initial random numbers. And suppose that I, as a teacher, ask the students to, for example, generate 3 random numbers and do their homework based on these 3 numbers. So as you can see, for example, Muhammad goes and runs this code. And if he runs the code, for example, he gets 6, 2, 5. And David runs the code again, he will get, for example, something like 5, 1, 5. And for example, Ali runs the code again, and he will get 3, 2, 5. And Alex, for example, would get something like this. So as you can see, every student is going to get different results, is going to get different random numbers. And for me as a teacher, it's very difficult to check their homework, because every one of them is using different initial values for doing their homeworks. And also there is another problem. For example, suppose that David runs the code and gets random numbers like this, 2, 3, 1. And even if David himself runs the code again, he will get different results. So it is not consistent. It is not repeatable. So even David himself cannot repeat his process. And in order to handle this problem, we want to use something called random seed. And please remember that explaining the meaning of random seed takes time. So if you don't understand the meaning of random seed at first, don't worry about it. You are going to understand that completely by the end of the video. So I can ask the class, I can ask the students to use random seed equals to, for example, let's say 42 or whatever number I want. But for example, let's say 42. So in order to do so, they can simply type np.random.seed, and for example, they should pass a number, and for example, suppose that I have told the class to pass 42. So if every of them pass 42 to this random seed, and if they run the code, they will get something like this. And if they run the code again and again and again, and if they run the code thousands of times, infinite number of times, they are going to get the same results. And now it is reproducible. So the general idea of using random seed is to make all this stuff reproducible, make something repeatable. So you can see that now every one of the students in this class can reproduce this result of generating random numbers, and all of them are going to get 4, 5, 3. So not only are they going to generate random numbers, but they are going to generate consistent random numbers, reproducible random numbers. So as long as anyone passes 42 to numpy.random.seed, they are going to get the same results. But for example, if anyone passes another number to numpy.random.seed, for example, suppose that someone passes 0 to numpy.random.seed, and if he runs the code, he will get something like this. So based on the value you pass to numpy.random.seed, you are going to get different results. But as long as you pass the same number to numpy.random.seed, everyone in the class will get the same results. In order to better understand the concept of random seeds, suppose this process of generating random numbers, which is a random process, consider this random process as an algorithm, which if you pass an initial value to this algorithm, you will get the output. So for example, if you pass to this algorithm, if you pass a value, an initial value, for example, equals to 0, then you are going to get the corresponding output. And as long as you pass 0 to this algorithm, you are going to get the same output. But if you change the input, for example, if you change the input from 0 to 42, you are going to get different outputs. So as long as you pass the same input to this random process, to this algorithm, you are going to get the same output. For example, in this example that we have talked, if you pass random seed equals to 0, then you are going to get 5, 6, 1 for generating 3 random numbers. And if you pass random seed equals to 42, you are going to get 4, 5, 3. But remember, as long as you pass 42, you are going to get 4, 5, 3 every time you run the code. But if you change the value, the input value, the initial value, the random seed, then you are going to get different results. But as long as you input the algorithm, the same value, you are going to get the same results. And remember that this concept of random seed is used in different packages of Python programming language. For example, it is used in sklearn for model selection, train, test, split, and doing all the stuff in different models. And also it is used in neural network, in keras, and pytorch, and those other packages which are available in Python. And it's a very, very important concept. It's a very useful and practical concept. So you should really know about this random seed. And as I have said, this concept of random seed is available in different packages. So far, we have talked about the NumPy package, but now let's talk about the random package in Python. And remember that random package is a built-in package, so you don't need to install that package because it's a built-in package in Python programming language. And now let's do the same thing that we have did in NumPy. And now suppose that we want to generate 3 random numbers between 1 to 6, like rolling a dice for 3 times. So we define an empty list, which is called, let's say, x. And then we use a for loop because the functions in the random package does not have any argument called size. So we should do that with the for loop. So I simply type for I in range of, for I in range of, for example, 3, because I want to generate 3 random numbers between 1 to 6. Then I'm simply using x.append because I want to append something to that list, which is called x. And the thing that I want to append to that list is random. It means from the random package, I want to use a function which is called randint. And I should pass 1 and 6. And remember that this 6 in the random package is inclusive. It's an exception. Because in a lot of places in Python programming language, as you have seen in the NumPy package, this second value is exclusive, but this is an exception, and this value in the random package is inclusive. That's it. So after appending that to the x list, then outside the for loop, if I print the x variable, which is our list, and if I run a code, we can see here we have three different numbers. And if I run the code again and again and again, it is possible to get different results because it's a random process. So now I can apply the same concept of random seed in this package as well. So I simply type random.seed. And for example, suppose that I want to pass 0. So if I run the code, you can see I get these results. And if I run the code again and again and again, I'm going to get the same results. And for example, if I pass 42, and if I run the code again and again and again and again, I'm going to get the same results, and it is reproducible. But here is another question that you may ask. Maybe you say, okay, I have passed random seed equals to 1, but in NumPy, I have get 5, 6, 1. And in random package, I've got 4, 4, 1. And also, I have passed random seed equals to 42, and I've got this in NumPy, and I've got this in the random package. So maybe you ask, what's the problem? And the answer is, there is no problem. Because the random package is using an algorithm, and the NumPy package is using a totally different algorithm. So the algorithms they are using is totally different. So if you pass a value to algorithm A, and if you pass the same value to another algorithm, let's say called algorithm B, you do not expect to get the same output because they are different algorithms. So the random package is using one algorithm, and the NumPy package is using another algorithm, which is totally different from the random package. So because they are using different algorithms for generating random numbers, then when you pass, for example, 0 to the NumPy, you will get this. And if you pass 0 to random module, you will get this. Now I really suggest you to watch this video, which is on the screen now.